But with us today is Rick London, who Rick is the owner and president of Dependable Auto Shippers, family business, 58. Rick started when he was one. No, but 58 years of business.
It's a 10-car hauler. It'll haul out to 10 cars. Most of them have to be small. I have 8 on today, but I have 5 SUVs, so I have to compensate for that because we have to make weight restrictions on all 3 sets of axles. And a gross weight, we can't be any more than 80,000 pounds, so I have to make weight, and each one of these cars makes up a part of that. The truck weighs 47,000 pounds by itself, so the remainder is in cars and fuel and me. Cars are backed on and driven on just over years of experience of figuring out how to cash the weight properly, so when I cross the scale, you can only have 12,000 pounds on the steers, and these back here can be 34,000 on the tractor and the trailer. So that's why a car is driven on or one's backed on, because where the motor is constitutes where the weight is cast onto the truck. A lot of times it's top loaded convertibles, or people will pay for it because everybody's car has a tendency to leak a little bit of fluid, and benefiting up top is you're not going to get the fluid dripping onto your car from somebody else's car that is going down the road, because you'll lose brake fluid, the transmission oil, any of the fluid your car has in it.
When you're trying to maximize your load, sometimes you have to put certain vehicles in certain positions. So if somebody wants it top loaded and you're going to be forced to put a vehicle on top that you normally put down in the belly, it can take away from your capacity. You could be hauling 8 cars instead of 9 or 7 instead of 8. So if you're going to be forced to be put up there, then you know it does become an efficiency issue and could get down to the load and everything else.
Quarter of a tank of fuel, because it's the weight issue. I mean, gas is 8 pounds a gallon, so you have a full tank in every one of these cars, that eats up weight, which limits if I can carry another vehicle or not. Stuff in people's cars, I mean, putting it nicely, we're not a household mover, we're there to move the car, and it puts me at liability if somebody leaves personal things in there and they disappear in transit, then they're going to say hi to them. So really nothing in a car, quarter tank of fuel, and
probably bring it clean.
You want it back the way you brought it, so bring it in.
If you can't do an inspection, you don't see all the scratches. If you look at your car just on a day-to-day basis, you're not going to see a lot of things. But all of a sudden, you really start looking at it after somebody else has touched it. That paint chip, that little scratch that's really been there for 2 years, all that stuff you see now. So keep it clean. Let them do an inspection. If you are going to put personal items in there, keep in mind, these cars are tied to the truck. They're actually chained down to the truck. So when the truck's bouncing, their cars are going to bounce a little bit more than what they would if you're driving. So anything in there, change. If you have, you know, change in your cup holder, I can almost guarantee that change is not going to be in the cup holder when it gets back. It's something in the back that's hard to break things. There's a very decent chance that it could damage the interior of your car, knock out glass, damage the outside of the car, because obviously if you break the glass got to go somewhere if you're going 60 miles per hour. So you got to be real careful with that stuff. If you just pile it up, you don't know what's going to happen by the time it gets to the end.
I've had baby strollers go through the rear windows from being back here, because the back of the truck just does this going down the road, and it just went right through where that SUV is right there. It goes down the road like this, so everything you have in that vehicle is now in the back of the car, no matter where you put it.
One, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. My father is making me sick with my face. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Wait to get on the road again. road again. Making music with my friends.